Yankoma lentombi
Yankoma lentombi Yankoma ngobuhlalo bomhlophe Phelazela lihle qabane lakho ntombi
Wathe kuhambeni wesikhashana nje
Yangeke iqabane lixhushwe ngobumnyama nakubovu Ngabe wenzenja Yingwe mabalabala yingwe Yingwe mabalabala yingwe
churches. Hopewell United Methodist in particular was very active. A number of philanthropic and charity groups.
Why don't you jump brand new?
At the event this year, we had so many things going on. There was a whole bunch of interactive stuff for kids and students and parents to all get involved in.
Games such as moon bounces, rock climbing walls, a bungee jump.
There were jugglers all over the place. There were several magicians, one who had a huge stage show.
First was a shack that was built by Habitat for Humanity. This was about the size of an SUV, and it showed a place where over 11 people can live in South Africa.
One of my favorite moments was watching this little kid, and his mother was with him and said, this is how people live. He said, so those are the people we're helping.
I saw some parents trying to explain that, those are 1,000 shoes, 1,000 people die every day in South Africa because of AIDS. Those displays were so incredibly powerful that it actually brought people to tears. And I remember one comment was that they never realized that it was that bad. We brought a little piece of South Africa back, and now hopefully we can bring a little piece of Westchester there. Cecil Begbie's Help Ministry Soup Kitchen is basically this man, Cecil, started this soup kitchen, and every day he cooks 40 pots of soup in his garage that he has turned into a kitchen.
We are currently feeding 5,000 school children on a daily basis into 8 primary schools.
Actually going to the classroom and watching these kids eat and how joyful and happy they were to get this meal forever changed my outlook on just a soup kitchen that you normally think about.
Sparrow Village is an AIDS orphanage where the people there adopt children who generally are infected with HIV. They give them a place to live before they will eventually die because of HIV and AIDS.
Seeing the kids and actually being in there was, something I'll never forget, because you actually were able to hold a person, a little kid that didn't do anything with AIDS, and like in your hand, and you're able to play with them and go in and see where they sleep and see where they go to school and what they eat, and just to see that, to see that there's so much hope with these kids who have this disease, and for them to have so much against them in the world and to have Sparrow Village to be that, the beacon for them, the shining beacon on the hill, is something that was awe-inspiring. You saw the abject poverty, but at the same time you also saw people smiling, you saw people playing, you saw kids making little go-karts all over the place. It was them living their lives, and they were doing the best they could with it, and they were enjoying it, they were loving life. Young.